both in the Kamiokande experiment and in the Homestake experiment by Davis, the number of neutrinos observed was too small. In the Kamiokande experiment in particular, you can only observe the neutrinos which come from boron 8. Only those have enough energy so the recoil electrons can be seen. But the Caltech experiments were good enough so one could tell with some accuracy how much boron will be formed in the interior of the sun, and therefore you could tell how many neutrinos there should be, and Kamiokande observed only half as many. Homestake, Davis, observed only about a quarter of the number of expected neutrinos. Well, that was a great puzzle. We now knew that neutrinos didn't come from the sun, but why then were there not enough? Well, first thing to blame was the nuclear physics at Caltech, and that's why the experiments were repeated and it was shown that they were all right. Second thing to blame was were the experiments. Now the Homestake experiments you could have some doubt about, but there was absolutely no doubt about the Japanese Kamiokande experiments. So it was quite clear that we did not see all the neutrinos that ought to come from the sun. Bahcall tried very hard to change the model of the sun, that is, to give the sun less central temperature that would diminish the formation of boron 8. No luck. Other people tried too, and Bahcall in the end proved that the standard model, which had been developed and which he had contributed most to, was correct, and that really the temperature at the center of the sun is 15 million degrees and not 13. So boron 8 should be produced.